Hello designers and mold makers, welcome to the WindyCAD. I'm your friend Vinayak. In this video, I brought an important and special calculation on mold cooling time. This video is going to be very special and this calculation you never going to find anywhere in YouTube, anywhere in the internet. I'm especially explaining this calculation to you. So hope you like the video. If you are new to the channel, I request you to subscribe the channel and do not skip the video, watch until the end. First of all, we'll check what we're going to learn today. So as a preview, I'm explaining importance of cooling, and let me clear you, I'm not going to explain a basic things of cooling. So we briefly will check importance of cooling. Cooling time depends on what factors, types of cooling, and I'm going to explain a little bit on Reynolds formula, and finally we'll learn how to calculate cooling time in a Microsoft Excel spreadsheet. Okay, this video I have already uploaded in Hindi language. If you are interested to watch it in Hindi, please check the playlist and you will find the video. First, we'll start with the importance of cooling. First point is constant mold temperature for uniform quality. If your mold temperature is equivalent along the mold surface, then your product quality going to be very perfect and quality going to be very uniform. The temperature plays a vital role in product quality, so cooling distribution is very essential. Please check my previous video on mold steel selection. In that video I have briefly explained how the steel selection and cooling affects mold surface temperature. Okay. Second point is reduction cycle time for productivity. As you are aware, 50 to 70% of cycle time mainly depends on cooling time. If you succeeded to reduce your cooling time, then your cycle time going to be reduced. So this results cycle time reduction and improve in your productivity. Third, improved surface finished without defects. If your cooling is very effective throughout the surfaces, as I mentioned in my first point, it's also reduce the defects also. For example, if your surface temperature is too high, then your melt temperature gets the heat and its viscosity may differ. If your viscosity of the material differ, then your part may get flashes or many other sigmas or such type of defects. Okay. Fourth point is avoiding warpages by uniform mold surface temperature. As you are aware, if your part is not cooled enough, then there will be an internal stress along the part. This results warpage. And last but not the least, if you succeed to achieve your successful cooling time, then your mold life going to be better. Your cooling time going to be depends on below factors. First, cooling medium used. Some cases oil going to be used, some cases water, and in some cases some cooling agents going to be circulated along with the water. Okay, that also depends on what medium you are using. And second is the conductivity of mold steel. As I mentioned, I made a video on mold steel selection. In that in depth I have explained conductivity of mold steel. Mold steel elements are very important in this case. Some chromium based mold steel and some carbon percent over mold steel plays a vital role in the conductivity. Those also plays an important role in cooling. And room temperature of the mold shop, as due to the global warming, is already 28 is a room temperature right now. 28 to 30 is a room temperature right now. It's very important to maintain a proper temperature in your mold shop. This also ambient temperature is very important to cool down the mold temperature. Fourth is the diameter of cooling hole, and fifth is the length of cooling circuit. This fourth and fifth point both are correlated to flow rate of the cooling line. If your diameter is too big and your length is too high, and your flow rate like LPM gallon per minute or liter per minute, this is going to be vary. For this, you have to select exact proportion of length and diameter. This I'm going to explain in next slide on flow rate. And position of your hole, that I already explained in the top 10 skills of mold maker. You please check the playlist and you'll find video. In that I explained a certain distance has to be maintained from surface of the cavity to the center of your hole. That has to be 2 times of your diameter, and pitch between two holes should be maintained 3 times of diameter. Okay, clear? Okay, we go to the next slide. Here I mentioned 2 types of flows. As I mentioned earlier, diameter of cooling hole and the length of the cooling circuit affects flow rate of the cooling medium. Also, there are 2 types of flow. One is laminar, another is turbulent. In laminar flow, fluid pass in a straight line. It won't create much turbulent. Due to this, heat transfer is very poor. In turbulent flow, due to its turbulence in flow, it create good heat transfer. As you are aware, surface of the any fluid gets the heat first. Then it has to go down at the core of the fluid. Then there should be a swipe between the layers. Then only efficient heat transfer. By using this Reynolds number formula, we can estimate whether our flow rate going to be laminar or turbulent. We need turbulent flow rate. So by the help of this formula, we can determine. I'm going to explain this formula in my upcoming video, as I feel it required much time and effort to make you understand, and even I should feel happy to make the lecture in a very good way. So I need little time, so we'll discuss in some other day. Okay, let me add you a fact. If you are a designer, always have an idea on flow rate of cooling medium at your production site. This is going to help you on any of the calculation. Always have idea on LPM or GPM, not an issue. Here we have entered Excel sheet to crack the calculation. Here I mentioned formula for cooling time. It's S square divided by pi square into R IN. IN means log 4 divided by pi. In the bracket, it's MT minus PT divided by DT minus VT. Okay, what is A? A is nothing but surface temperature of cavity. By the help of this chart, we can find the value of A with the help of this surface temperature. Here I have taken 50, it's of DT, and I have mentioned value of A. With the help of this chart, you will find it, and it is going to be very easy. Okay, next, we have found A. IN means it's a log. Let me show you by clicking the calculator. I'll just show you. Okay, here you can find the log IN. Okay, in Excel also we can do the same thing. Okay, now 4 divided by pi, it's a constant, no need to change this value. Okay, MT and PT. MT is a melt temperature. Okay, it's a 250. Fine. And a PT is a ejection temperature. You can say it's a demolding temperature. Okay, here I have mentioned it's a PT. And DT is surface temperature of the mold. With the by help of this DT, I have derived A, heat efficiency rate. I derived by help of the surface temperature 50, I taken for ABS. It's A. Okay, I took same formula into cells. Here you can see it's MT minus PT divided by DT minus PT. From left side, we're going to start our formula of calculation. And this cell, I have written the same formula by clicking the each cell, by linking the each cell which is having the respective values. Okay, this MT minus PT, the melt temperature minus ejection temperature, the same way I have written. Okay, in the third, same value going to appear, but my 4 divided by pi, that value I have taken down. Okay, you can by clicking shift F3, you can insert pi, and by dividing both the values in this cell, I'll be having the final answer of 4 divided by pi. Okay, in this left side, the main formula brought down, and here 4.4 divided by pi that I brought down. Okay, both I'm going to multiply in this cell. Okay, this both value I multiplied and bought in this cell. Okay, fine. Now I'm going to log it. Okay, for that I'm going to double click it. Okay, here I can see the log, equal log. Okay, and just check how I'm going to get the value. Okay, fine. Now I got my final answer. This left side we completed. Now we want to find the right side. Okay, this is quite simple. The S means your wall thickness. Wall thickness square I did two times, should be multiplied with the same value. Okay, now A pi already aware 3.14 of square, and that has to be multiplied with the value of A. Okay, to get the multiplication symbol, you just type a shift 6 and you will get upper arrow, and that going to be your square. Okay, finally we got the answer. Okay, fine. If you change the sheet thickness, your cycle your cooling time going to be vary, as if you change the thickness, the mass going to be high, then your cooling time also going to be high. Okay, this is a way you going to find your cooling time. I think I explained in a very simpler way. I hope you understood. Okay. If you learn something new today, please hit the like button, and if you are new to our channel, please subscribe the channel. If you are having any sort of doubts regarding the calculation, I request you to comment below. I try to resolve all of them, and I need little suggestion on what language you are preferring to watch my videos. This is going to help me a lot to decide my language, and I'll come up with another exciting, interesting subject. Till then, take care of you, stay safe, be at home, and we'll meet in next video. Thank you.